This is an interesting contest we have up here. We have the big man. I'm not sure Van Sleek on Third Indian Dragon.
Van Sleek? Mike, respect the Dutchman. Van Sleek.
Excuse me, Van Sleek.
I'm Dutch, so. Well, I'm not like from Holland, but my family is. Showing shades of Dick the Bruiser and the Crusher. Pun Van Sleek with a whole new getup. And he looks like an absolute killer.
Now, talk to me about how Punisher Van Sleek has developed since he started here in Garden State Wrestling and moved his way up the card.
Once his opponent comes out, I will explain it thoroughly because I was there for most of it. Apparently, they're having a hard time. Satanic Road? Disturbed Damien Dragon making his way to the ring. The Edge of Sanity against the Straight Edge Suplex Machine. What's happening, man?
Yeah, definitely interested to see how this contest breaks down.
Alright, so let's talk about the fabled history of Punisher Van Sleek making his way, coming in August 2010 with, BKNY. Taking on Bruno DeMeo and Vin Gerard. And back then, Pun was just starting to make his way in the business. I think he had been doing it for about 6 months at the time. He's simply known as Big Pun then. I had a discussion with him.
Uh-oh, the poisonous red mist.
And then he came back and took on Danny Inferno and Jason Gotti. And Pun picked up the victory against two. One was a former Garden State champion, and the other was, it's actually been in a couple documentaries, and Pun picked up the victory. Slowly but surely, just coming into his own, and then at the last show here, Susquehanna Community College put on a clinic with his actual tag team partner, Kevin the Man Graham. One of the best matches I've ever seen.
And referee Matt Derlane is now being the coat rack and hat rack for Damien Dragon here.
Matt has never looked better. Never looked better.
He definitely looks sharp. Resembles young Mr. Fuji.
He looks like he just came from a Kutztown farmer's market.
And apparently Damien Dragon calling for the bell. If you're Punisher Van Sleek, what do you make of this guy in the psych out tactics?
He looks like he wants to devour him. Not only eat his lunch, eat his children, but eat his self. That was an intelligent comment. All right, and a lock up here. Pun backs him into the corner. You can definitely tell the size disparity right now between the two.
Exactly, but you have to keep in mind as well, the poisonous red mist that we saw on the entrance of Damien Dragon. Is that a sign of things to come, possibly?
Damien Dragon just tagged in Matt Derlane. I'm just saying that. This guy is...
But isn't it true that you nearly have to be on the point of madness to be at your peak potential as an athlete and a competitor? Would that be a fair statement to make? As apparently we are looking at a modified crane stance.
Well, Ralph Macchio was from New Jersey, so maybe Ralph Macchio came back and trained Damien Dragon. In the ways of... the guy that he trained with in Karate Kid.
It was Miyagi Karate.
Miyagi, no.
Not to be confused with Machida Karate.
No, not Machida Karate. And
as Punisher Van Sleek trying to turn the arm ringer into an arm lock, and
Damien Dragon continuing doing kip, and now he is apparently taking up breakdancing.
And apparently he is thoroughly confused and frustrated by his efforts. I think it's a safe statement to say Disturbed Damien Dragon is inside Punisher Van Sleek's head. Now we're going to have to see how Punisher Van Sleek makes the adjustments.
The gut wrench.
An excellent way to adjust right there with the gut wrench. Working up forward into an ankle lock.
Damien Dragon going over to his back. He wants to make sure he keeps his shoulders up, but well, doesn't worry about that because he's there. But into a headlock. You know, I guess any way that you can get to your destination is a good way.
Amazing transition. Shoots him off the ropes. Runs into the brick wall as Punisher Vance Leck wasn't going nowhere. Challenges him to come off the other side. Sets. No change in the result.
Mike, you said you'd know what it's like being hit by a Mack truck. You ever run into a wall like this?
Yes, I've run into a few walls.
I'm talking about inside the wrestling ring.
Inside of wrestling, yes, and I've also had anvils drop on me from ceiling. And I can only speculate from here what referee Matt Delaney and Damian Dragon are talking about, possibly his chances at another shoulder tackle to see how it'll work.
Are they literally discussing their match in the ring? Why would you want to give your opponent, why would you want to let your opponent know exactly what you're going to do? Oh, maybe that's why. Big eye poking. Oh, and that didn't work. It got exactly what he wanted. Oh, things are back in.
Punisher Vance Leck going for a backland roll. Rolls through. Too quick.
Huge arm drag. Damian Dragon really knows his way around a wrestling ring. He's showing it right now. Any way it comes, I guess. But there's the wheelbarrow. And into another arm drag.
Modified technique we saw from the last match with Mike Mitchell is the beautiful reverse wheelbarrow into the arm drag. And Punisher Vance Leck better not stop moving because here comes Dragon.
Pun looks visibly frustrated. The first half of this match so far, he's spent basically trying to understand who this guy is. Now this guy is taking it to him.
Don't take your offers. Ooh.
Well, that's why you don't take your eyes off.
Big form for the second. Ooh.
A big high kick, and Punt catches him into a big, whoa, faraway slam.
Style suplex. Definitely with high impact moves like that, you can earn the moniker the straighted suplex machine. Let's see how big Punisher Vance Leck finishes up. Let's see how he follows up. What do you think his best chance to put Damian Dragon away is?
You know what his best thing you could do is probably put him away is right now if you were to pick him up by his head like he's doing right now and throw him from one end of the ring into the other end of the ring. If he hits a couple turnbuckles in the way, I guess that's a way to win. If you go back all the way to the match I was watching the other day between Buddy Rogers and Pat O'Connor, that was the entire match. Going from one turnbuckle to the other turnbuckle to the other turnbuckle. You know what? That put away stronger men than what we have right now. So maybe that's what you should do. You should just pick him up by his head, and you should just throw him directly into the ring post. I think that would be a good way to win the match.
Now, Punisher Vance Leck has definitely slowed the tempo down, but playing possum, Damian Dragon with the roll-up and two count. Confused and disorder. No confused bat. All business, shoulder block, clothesline, into sternum first across the knee is Damian Dragon. That may have knocked the wind right out of him.
He doesn't have a lot of wind to gather either. Because he's been bouncing all around.
Referee Matt Dillon in to see if he needs him to stop the match. As Punisher Vance Leck slowly following up. I think he's plotting and planning his next moves. This is going to hurt. Big chop across the chest.
Ooh. That wasn't like one of those flashy chops that you hear all over the place. That was directly into the chest.
That wasn't aesthetically pleasing. It's now into the Kona crush.
The Oswego crush, he told me.
The Oswego crush.
The Oswego crush. It's from Oswego, New York. And, okay. I don't think Punk's seen any kind of daylight, let alone anything in Hawaii. The Oswego crush right now, and that is enough to crush numerous fruit along with skulls.
I'm interested to see how Damian Dragon going to fight his way out of here with the vice grip as he gets a little steam. And hits a knee, the kitchen sink coming across the ring.
A knee right to the gut.
And that's not to the top of the belly, that's the lower abdomen, a very sensitive and tender area. And now Punisher Vance Leck executing very well using the reverse knife edge chops, hopefully to knock the wind and possibly slow down.
Damian Dragon
is another roll up, another one, roll up, one, two.
He just didn't have enough weight to keep those shoulders down. Damian Dragon off the ropes right now and picks him up, going up, for a crucifix. And Pun grabs him by his neck and picks him up and puts him right back up and then kicks him directly in the gut.
And we're looking at a gut-wrench
powerbomb.
Doctor Bomb style.
That was a Doctor Bomb. You were right.
One, two.
That was a little bit too much confidence. He should have hooked the leg. He should have put more pressure. It looks like he's putting pressure on his gut.
I have to call him a Damian Dragon is extremely resourceful in finding ways to get out of these submission holds and these high-impact slams. You got to admire his heart and his perseverance because he definitely wants to win because a win over Punisher Vance Leck could definitely be a feather in his cap towards a title shot of his choice.
You know, when Damian Dragon came out of here, he was using a lot of tactics to get ahead of Pun. And It may have worked in the beginning, but now that we've actually broken down into this match, we're showing that Davey Dragon is more than just parlor tricks and smoke and mirrors. He can really get out there and really can push the tempo.
Those knife-edge chops across the chest are dangerous. They knock the breath right out of you. If you can't breathe, you can't move.
You can't move
and you're in the ring with Bunch of Vance Like, you're dead meat. And looking to set up the superplex.
Big headbutts down upon.
Highly effective, right across the bridge of the nose.
And, oh, Pun almost took the big nasty plunge.
He may have knocked Big Pun for a loop. He's dragging to the top rope, and this is a bad spot for Pun.
Yeah, this is not good.
Dragging big crossbody. Excellent.
He didn't make the cover, though. He did not make the cover. That could have been something that
he hit him with such force, he bounced off.
He could have easily put him down for three with the calf kick.
Zero Zen kick made famous by Dean Malenko. Followed up by a modified Busaki knee kick. One, two. Last second kick out.
That was a 2.9 kind of kick out, too. Dean Malenko's my favorite wrestler, you know?
No, I've never heard that, actually.
He's my absolute favorite.
Punisher Vance Like is obviously disoriented. And
now he's taking too much time.
With the support of that crowd, this may need what Damian Dragon needs to turn the match around. Misses the forearm. This could be bad. Big knee to the gut.
Oh, and he hooks it. He hooks it in the butterfly position.
Butterfly hook. Where does he go from this?
Oh, this could be very, very, very awful in a second. Pun looking around, literally like, where do you want me to drop this guy? Because I could end his life right now.
As this is going, the blood is rushing right to his head. He'll be extremely disoriented when
he hits. I think he's using this as a submission hold.
A modified Gordy clutch into the butterfly suplex. All impact. Oh,
that
Lord,
a stalling butterfly suplex. What a way to do that. One, two, three. I thought that was the end of the match right there. I am not even joking.
And I'm amazed he can even make it to his feet after that as Punisher Vance Like follows in, stopped by the knee.
Oh, the Enziguri right now.
Kick to the side of the head. Let's see what he follows
set up. Into
tornado DDT, beautiful. Proximity to the ropes. One, two, almost.
Whoa. Damian Dragon obviously not realizing that was a two count on Matt Durlin.
Matt Durlin nearly counted himself out of the match. You can tell Punisher Vance Like had to be disoriented. The ropes right there that he had to use all his resources available to kick out. Now he's chopping him down.
Damian Dragon doing right now what Pun is not doing. Pun is not laying into Damian Dragon with huge, big strike. Damian Dragon using...
Fireman's lift. Where does this come to?
It may not matter now. Ooh. Big Fireman's carry power bomb. One, two, and three. It is over. Punisher Vance Like, your winner.
After taking an extreme amount of punishment, Punisher Vance Like resourcefully gathered skills, perseverance to defeat Damian Dragon. But we gotta say, Damian Dragon, an excellent showing.
You said excellent while he threw up the X.
That'll be internet meme somewhere.
There you go. Is it meme or meme? That doesn't matter. Anyway, Punisher Vance Like, your winner. Damian Dragon, great showing here.
Maybe we can go ask Jesse Levino. He spends a lot of time in the internet looking at stuff that nobody cares about.
Well, that's not nice to say.
Punisher Vance Like with an excellent win. This is definitely going to move him up the ranks of Garden State Wrestling. Damian Dragon with an amazing performance, taking the big man right to the very end. And I think the fans appreciate both efforts of these athletes in the ring tonight.
And Pun walking away lonely like he came in here the same way. This man... he may be tagged with Kevin Graham. Kevin Graham has been much more on the fan favorite side. I don't know how long these guys are going to be able to stay on the same side, because Pun Vance Like looks like a man on a mission right now.
I imagine strictly it's got to be a business relationship. You don't exceed and excel in this wrestling business by making friends, by being everybody's buddy.
That is absolutely true. Damian Dragon, give it up for him, everybody. There you go. A man that, different strategies are what win you matches. And he absolutely had a different strategy, maybe one too many times, going with his getting inside the head of Pun Vance Like. Maybe it's a way to stay more focused.
Different strokes for different throats.
That is absolutely true.
And you can tell the crowd appreciates as Damian Dragon is actually able to leave under his own power.
And now he's dragging a fan.
And now for video evidence, I don't know if this is going to be videotaped or not, but this is not kidnapping yet.
No, you don't touch my daughter.
And that was by far the strangest thing that I have seen. So, okay. Back to action.
Did Damian Dragon place him on timeout? I'd probably wait till he got back to the curtain to go over and sit next to his daughter again.
Well, I guess, I mean, if you can come away from a match like that and understand that you're not, number one, dead, and number two, that you put out quite the effort, then I guess that's a win.